back in the 1960s and 70s, there was one set of facts, fundamentally, that we got from, you know, Walter Cronkite and the network news shows, who in turn got their sort of fundamental frame from a few institutions like the New York Times. But we all fundamentally began with the same set of facts. You don't need me to tell you that that's a very different situation than we're in now. But newspapers especially, and I'm from a newspaper background, so perhaps I'm prejudiced, but newspapers especially had a societal role, and I mean a local one, of identifying the common weal in a community. And I think that's one of the reasons why, despite what you've heard about the newspaper business, most newspapers, vast majority of newspapers, are now making an operating profit. And the newspapers that have gone out of business, for the most part, were the second newspaper in a town. But people in a community have generally basically understood that the newspaper, the institution of newspaper, was very important to the social fabric, not only because it tended to be the objective source of news, it was the news utility. Broadcast television, local television, has never been willing to take on that kind of repertorial role in many respects. And that objectivity is still, I think, fundamentally still the approach of reported serious news as the role of the newspaper in a community. The Boston Globe does virtually all of the serious political reporting in Boston, and I think that's true of most towns.